Now, Mr. Wilbur, these are photos of tires belonging to the defendant's car. And these are photos of the tire marks left by the assailant's car as it fled the convenience store. Now, are you familiar with these?
Yes, I am.
Uh-huh. Could you elaborate, please, sir?
We compared the tire marks outside the convenience store with the rear tires of the defendant's car. They're the same model and size tire. Michelin model XGV, size 75R, 14-inch wheel.
They're the same size and model tire. Anything else, sir?
Yes, indeed. The car, leaving the convenience store, spun its rear tires dramatically and left a residue of rubber on the asphalt. Now, I took a sample of that rubber and analyzed it. I also took a sample of the rubber from the rear tires of the defendant's Buick and analyzed that, too.
What kind of equipment did you use to find this out?
I used a Hewlett-Packard 57-10A dual-column gas chromatograph with flame analyzation detectors.
Uh-huh. Is that thing turbocharged?
Only on the floor models.
Now, Mr. Wilbur, what was the result of your analysis?
The chemical composition between the two samples was found to be identical.
Identical. No further questions, Your Honor.
Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Wilbur.
Court will take a 60-minute recess for lunch.